Welcome to Let's Pod Crime. This week I'll be covering Pedro Rodriguez Filho, whose kill count hit 10 by the time he turned 18 years old. In total, his count stands somewhere between 70 and over 100 kills. He is described as being the perfect psychopath. Born on the 17th of June 1954 in Santa Rita, Brazil. Even before he was born, he suffered damage to his skull after his father kicked his mother in the stomach while she was pregnant with him, damaging his skull. A trait which is often credited with changing people's mentality and turning them into killers. During his childhood, he was abused by his father. Taking this into account and the damage to his skull, this had no doubt affected him for the rest of his life. By the age of 13, he already had the urge to kill, pushing his older cousin into a sugar cane press, but he was unsuccessful. One thing that makes Filho different than most serial killers, his murders had motive, most of which were direct revenge. It was at the tender age of 14 years old that he killed his first victim. His father was working as a security guard at a local high school and had been accused of stealing food from the kitchen. As a result of this, he was fired from his job by the vice mayor, something which Filho clearly didn't agree with. Taking the matter into his own hands, he took a shotgun and killed the vice mayor of Alfenzas. A month later, he killed the security guard that is believed to have actually been stealing the food. As a result of this, he fled the area and took refuge in Mogi das Cruz in Santa Paulo, where he robbed drug dealers' dens, slums, and even started to murder human traffickers. It was during this time that he fell in love with Maria Aparecida Olimpia. The pair got engaged and quickly Maria became pregnant. However, it wouldn't be the fairy tale ending they had hoped for. Instead, it would be the start of a true rampage of hate, anger, and revenge. Filho's unborn child and wife were both killed when gang leaders in the area executed Maria. There was no chance that Filho would let this lie. Instead, he rounded up several soldiers and went on a killing spree, both killing and torturing his way to find out who had killed the love of his life and his unborn child. Learning that the gang leader had set up a wedding for one of his close friends, Filho and his soldiers crashed it, killing 7 people in total and injuring a further 16. Filho was still only 17 years old at this point. He learned that his favourite cousin had become pregnant by her boyfriend, but he refused to marry her. So Filho took revenge in the only way he knew and shot the male, killing him. The next person to die at his hands was none other than his own father. He learned that his father was in jail for killing and dismembering his mother's body with a machete. Filho went and visited his father in jail and proceeded to stab him 22 times with a machete. Once he finished stabbing him, he cut out his heart and took a bite out of it. He would continue to kill, maim and torture gang members in the area, using his favourite techniques of stabbing or hacking people up with blades. In some cases, he would change his MO, and if he was killing a serial killer, he would adopt their technique and use it against them. For this, he became known as the real-life Dexter. Over the course of the next 2 years, he would go on the run and kill as many serial kills and drug deals as he possibly could, before finally being arrested on the 24th of May 1974. During his arrest, he was placed in the back of a police van with 2 other people. Despite the fact that all 3 of whom had been arrested were in handcuffs, officers were shocked when they opened the rear door and saw that one of the males had been killed. Filho had killed him and claimed that the male was a rapist. At just 19 years old and after multiple murders, torturing and kidnaps, Filho was sentenced to 126 years in jail. It is safe to say that Filho was not a model prisoner and would have to actually fight for his own life. During one attack, he was jumped by 5 other inmates. He managed to fight back and kill 3 of them, and went on to chase the other 2 down as they fled. He killed other prisoners for their past crimes. He killed one inmate because he snored too loudly. One he killed simply because he did not like his face. In total, he would kill 47 other inmates, while attempting to kill many more. Several were bludgeoned and stabbed, while at least one is known to have been decapitated. Filho claimed that his total stood at over 100, however, this could not be proven, and only 71 confirmed victims can be. As a result of his killings, while incarcerated, another 274 years were added on to his sentence, taking his grand total to 400 years. Of these 400 years, he would serve only 34. Part of Brazilian law states that no one can serve more than 30 years behind bars. He was set for release in 2003, but due to the killings while in jail, a further 4 years were tacked on. In 2007, he was released. During his time in jail, he started a relationship with a female prisoner who was serving a 12-year sentence for theft. In 2011, he was rearrested and convicted for rioting and false imprisonment for past crimes committed while in Sao Paulo. He was sentenced to a further 128 years. However, as previously mentioned, that no one can serve more than 30 years in Brazil, a decree was signed in 1934 by President Vargas that any psychopath can be detained indefinitely in psychiatric establishments for treatment. This was overturned by decree number 99678 on the 8th of November 1990. As a result of this, Pedro Rodriguez Filho was released in 2018. Since then, he has set up his own YouTube channel where he talks about his life. Psychiatrists described him as being the perfect psychopath who displayed antisocial traits and was very clever with an almost perfect photographic memory. To cement his love of killing, he had "I kill for pleasure" tattooed on his left arm. Thank you for joining me for this week's Let's Pod Crime.